privacy from the audience. So on that side of the curtain, you have sets that come up and down. You have artists that move often the side. So for Broadway, for dance, for opera, you actually need this type of configuration so they can tell the story that they need to tell on the stage. For a concert hall, this big box, you see the big wood frame, massive. That entire thing flies up into the stage tower. It completely goes all the way up past that what you see there, the oculus and the circles, that's called a reflector, okay? This big proscenium flies completely up, and behind this, there's a piece of architecture that connects to, do you have your zapper? This is Spencer Tong, our EVP of operations. We have a piece of architecture which will take you to the back, and we'll raise the curtain in a minute, that connects, see that's the proscenium opening. Okay, these balconies will connect to a piece of architecture that weighs 500 tons, and it connects, and so it becomes a theater kind of in the round. Hard to explain right now, but once we lift the curtain, you'll have the chance to see it. So let's do this first. Spencer, we have how many rows?
22
rows of chairs. We're not flipping all 22 rows because where Spencer's standing, that's part of the stage for Rise and Shine. Okay, so we're gonna leave that right where it is. You ready to go?
Ready to go.
Thank you.
Right.
Everybody's loving the curtain rod?
Okay, so with the proscenium hall, okay, this is the proscenium opening. These speakers are to amplify the work that's being on the other side of the proscenium. Okay, it needs to push the sound out because the sound is going to get caught up in here. When we walk back here, you'll see it. What happens when we change the hall, this flies up, which you see in the back, and this piece of architecture back here, see this piece back here? You guys see that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they connect all the way to here. So there's train tracks that pushes that. This is a million pounds. These are two towers that are like the connectors to connect that big piece of architecture to this. It will make more sense when we walk back there. What you see here, this is the setup for Rise and Shine for Friday nights there in rehearsal. So all of these curtains go away. And when we walk back there, you'll see on this piece of architecture right here, the completion of the reflector, which is up here. Okay, so this is the reflector. When it's one room, the sound is all going to be in one space, one volume of space. It's not going to get caught up into a stage tower. It's all going to be in one room, and this reflector helps push the sound out. Now, why we call this room is like an instrument is, do you see these boxes right here? All of these?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
These are all fabric panels. And they're way up here, and they're all the way in the back. They're on every level, all around here. And they rise and they lower because reflection is very important, and reverberation is very important with music. So depending on the art form and how bright you want the room or soft, that's what you move up and down to try to control the sound of what's on the stage.
Another unique thing that I like about the theater is in the back, all of that also converts into actual seating.
Yeah. So we'll take you up there. Oh, we can't because it's in the back. If you come back, we'll be happy to take you there. But you can sit behind there. So for instance, for Leon Bridges, for Jennifer Hudson, for Lyle Lovett, for a lot of the concerts, you can sit behind the orchestra and you watch the conductor, which is a very common thing in concert halls. Right? So you have just a total perspective. So you can actually walk all the way around. So you would walk here, right onto there, and all the way around, and that's moved up. Two completely separate rooms, styles of rooms. So this is a proscenium hall. The other hall would be a concert hall.